What really makes Morph-O-Matic unique is its ability to handle progressive morphing. What is progressive morphing, you might ask? Well, this is exactly what I will show you in this video. Progressive morphing allows us to define specific in-between objects to be used at specific moments in a morph channel. So on this object, I will apply a Morph-O-Matic modifier and load a target. The target I will load will be a finger bent at 100%. Here is the result where we can see the finger being bent very nicely. But how does it look when we are at, let's say, 50%? Not very good, right? The problem can be explained by the vertices, the points composing the object. They look for the shortest trajectory in a straight line, a linear line, from when they are at one position to the next. The shortest line in this example is this direction here. What we can do in Morph-O-Matic that is very unique is that we can define as many targets as we want and specify which specific percentage they need to be used. So let's do just that. Select the targets, and for each of them, define at which value they need to be used. You can use as many as you want, and you can use them in any value that you wish. So here I will restrict this channel to work from -20% to 100%. Now, from -20%, we can see that the finger can go higher up than the hand in a natural way, and we have a very nice curve on the way to 100%. The idea is that because Morph-O-Matic uses cubic interpolation, we obtain a very nice curve when we blend from one target to another. The result is very smooth. We don't see any of the targets because we are actually animating through many targets at once in this channel. This gives us the ability to animate things that are not moving in a straight line, which is a very typical problem of morph targets. I will show you another very cool example with Donner here from Rainbow Studios. So as we can see, this character has very big eyeballs. Within Morph-O-Matic, we have the ability to filter predefined channels, so we can select to see only the eyelid channels. As in the previous example, Morph-O-Matic allows to smoothly go from open to closed using in-betweens. This allows us to have the eyelids follow the curve of the eyeballs without ever creating what is called interpenetration. The character's mesh at this time is not being subdivided. So let's just add a turbo smooth modifier to showcase the results. Again, we can see that we have created a very nice curve. The main idea is that we can really use our creativity and design targets that are specific in-betweens for our animations, allowing us to create exactly what we want while not being restricted to point A to point B linear target style animations. Thank you for watching this presentation on progressive morph target animations. You can find the trial version of Morph-O-Matic and other Di-O-Matic software on our website at www.diomatic.com.